WinCC version 8 tips and tricks number 3, working with animations in Graphics Designer. Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure animations in WinCC's Graphics Designer. The great thing is you can change multiple properties with just one tag or expression. Be sure to watch to the end of the video when I talk about performance warnings and expressions. You don't want to miss that. So let's get started. So I've got this screen in my project, and this is the WinCC step-by-step project, and these pumps and valves and the tank and a few other things, these are Siemens HMI symbol library objects, and you can change the color on these. You can also make them blink. Well, WebUX does not support the Siemens HMI symbol library. They only support the SVG libraries, so I have to change these objects to SVG, and it's a good opportunity for me to show you one of the newer animation tools in Graphics Designer. It's called Animations. First, let's take a look at the pump and let's see what we've got on there. I've got this dynamic dialogue that is on blink mode and it's using the red pump fail, so it blinks if red pump fail is on. And then we also have a dynamic dialogue which changes the pump to red if the power's on, green if the power's off. And then of course there's also a direct connect that shows a pop-up window. So we'll open the SVG library, and we've got library version 1 and 2, and it's kind of organized similarly to the symbol libraries, and I'm just going to use this cool pump. SVG libraries are very efficient for web, but they don't give you all the functionality that you get from an ActiveX, which is to be expected. So, for instance, if we look at the properties on this cool pump, notice how all the flashing stuff is disabled. So it'll let me try to put a dynamic dialog on here, but if I add something, notice how these are all disabled. So these just don't work. So we're not going to be able to do flashing on this. Also notice that we can't change the color under the colors. These are all grayed out, but there are some symbol properties here. We've got a basic color and a contrast color, and we're going to use these to change the pump from red to green based on whether or not it's on or off. So if we look at our basic color, just kind of give the basic a dark green, the contrast a light green, then that looks pretty nice. But I'm going to have to put a dynamic dialog on two different properties in order to get it to change. Well, with animations, you don't really have to do that. So I'm going to show you very quickly how to use animations. I'm going to right click and I'll choose animation on the property that I want to change. We'll do add new animation, and very much like dynamic dialog, it's looking for a tag. So I'll just go pick my tag out, which is going to be my structure tags, red. And we want to change this color based on whether it's on or not, so I'll do red pump on. And here's where the magic happens with animations. I'll add a property, and there's my basic color, but I can add a second property, which is my contrast color. So I can change as many properties as I want based on one expression or one set of tags. So this is going to be a Boolean data type, and if this tag is on, then our basic color is going to be kind of this darker red, and our contrast color is going to be kind of a brighter red. And then if the pump is off, then it's going to be darker here and lighter here. And it's going to be on a tag trigger, triggering at 1 second. So now we can kind of go test this out. I'll save this. And in runtime, I'll just leave this page and come back. There's our pump. And if I turn the pump off, you can see both colors change, and if I start it, both colors change. So the biggest difference with animations is that I can affect multiple properties at the same time. And if you're using a customized object, you may have text in there saying, hey, the pump is on, and then you also have a color indicating if it's on or off based on color. It can be a lot more efficient in your animations. Okay, so I've converted this overview screen to use all SVG objects. If we hit save, then our output window doesn't have any problem with it. So I've converted my valves, I've all my red hoppers, my tank, even my little droplet here. These are all converted over to SVG objects. And I've done animations, I've done some dynamic dialogues on these. So we can save this and just take a quick look at runtime. So you can see everything still works. We're changing our pumps and valves. Here we're doing our alarm, so I made the pump text flash instead of the pump because SVG doesn't support that. Now, one really, really important thing you have to know about doing animations. So let's say that I want to turn the supply label yellow if both my pump and valve fail is on. I will go to my properties of this supply label, and I'll go to flashing. We'll do flashing text active, and I'm going to do animation. And then for animation, I'll add one, and I'm going to choose expression because I want to use more than one tag. I want to do an and. So I will choose red pump fail, and I can just type and. And then I'll do red valve fail. So if they're both on, it should trigger this animation. I'll add my property, so I'll do flashing text active, and we'll set that to Boolean. And if both of these tags are on, we'll just set it to yes. Okay, everything looks great, so let's just save. One thing immediately that comes up, I get a performance warning. One action with a cyclic trigger. Well, a cyclic trigger means it's being run based on time rather than on tags changing. So if we go back to this, I can just double click here and notice that it's set to the default trigger, which is 1 second. Well, we don't really want that. We want this to trigger when either one of these tags, the red valve fail or the red pump fail, changes state. That's the only time this ever needs to be triggered. And so what you need to do is go back to these. If you use an expression and you just add those tags as triggers, and that way it's going to run exactly when it needs to, when either of the two tags come in. All right, so if I do that, then I save. I no longer get my performance warning. Now, if I were to do this same thing with a dynamic dialog, it would handle it. You could put multiple tags in the expression line. It adds these automatically to the trigger, but animations have not caught up with this. So really, really good advice here. If you do an expression with multiple tags, you must put those tags in the trigger list in order to avoid your performance warnings. And trust me, you want to do that. Okay, so quick recap here. Animations are great. They allow you to change multiple properties with one tag change or an expression. But if you're using an expression in an animation with multiple tags, they default to a cyclic trigger, and you don't want this. It's a performance issue. So be sure and add all the tags in your expression to your tag trigger list, and you'll have a very efficient project. Thanks for watching. If you like this, give me a thumbs up, a like. Be sure to subscribe for more great videos on WinCC.